TB4000 stands at the cutting edge of energy systems and stands to revolutionise the way we generate power. We believe that this is the first commercially viable free energy system. In conventional power generating plants, energy is inefficiently converted from one form to another. In a free energy system, more energy is generated than is used. By partially closing the loop, we can create a perpetual machine that generates free energy. Many scientists would have you believe that free energy is impossible. However, there are many gaps in scientific knowledge. The engineers behind the TB4000 exploited these gaps to build our revolutionary machine. For example, scientists can't explain how a bumblebee can fly. Scientists have witnessed unexplained forces acting on space probes. Scientific theories are unable to fully explain the origin of magnetism. The secret to how our engineers have exploited some of these holes in scientific knowledge lies in these transparent domes on the rotor. If you were to place a bee in one of the domes and a flower in another, the bee would have no choice but to use its telekinetic ability to try and move closer to the flower. Of course, using bees and flowers to power a machine is absurd. For one thing, bumblebees are a protected species, and it can also be hard to get fresh flowers all year round. So instead of the flower, we use a piece of corned beef. Instead of the bee, we turn to the close relative of the bee, the fly. Flies may be weaker than bees, but they are plentiful and can be reared all year round at a low cost. Flies are kept in a hibernation state by cooling them down. The warm light soon wakes the fly, and as soon as the partition is removed, the rotor starts to move. We've commissioned a well-known architects firm to create this stunning scale model of a proposed full-scale power plant. However, before we can build such a plant, we're seeking funding to pass two hurdles. The first is to scale up our components and breed a strain of superfly. Secondly, we hope to reduce friction losses to the point where we no longer need the supplementary assistance from this motor.